Welcome viewers to Ek Mulaqat. I'm your host, Ravi Shastri. Today I have with me a very special guest, talented, multifaceted actor, producer, dancer, etc., etc. Her list of qualifications is endless. Please welcome to the studio Kalpana Pandit. Kalpana, thank you very much for joining us today.
Thank you very much, Ravi, and good evening, viewers. It's a pleasure to be on Ek Mulaqat, and I'm here to be grilled by Ravi.
We're going to give her a hard time, guys. We're going to give her a real hard
time.
Go
for it.
Tough questions. Tell me, organic chemistry. No, I'm just joking. All right. But no, thank you so much for coming down here. I know your time is precious. The viewers might be wondering, what you're up to. Kalpana, tell me, what brings you to Silicon Valley?
Oh, that's the greatest question you can start with, Ravi, because I've had a fantastic experience working on my brand new film. It's a bilingual film in Hindi and Tamil, and feature film. And we have been working nonstop now for the past almost 2.5 months. It's a commercial thriller, romantic genre, and I'm working with a very hot and happening co-star who Ravi will talk about in a little bit, I guess. And this film is being produced by Dreams on Frames, an American company of Indian professionals out here in Silicon Valley, and also my own little company called House of Pandits. So I'm very excited.
So you are co-producing. House of Pandit is your production company, you are co-producing.
Absolutely.
This movie, which is shot in Silicon Valley,
yep.
And from what I understand, it's shot in India as well.
It is going to be shot in India.
It's starring, obviously you, Kalpana Pandit. It's starring Ganesh Venkatraman, mm-hmm. who is a pretty well-known actor in South India.
Mm-hmm.
Hot and happening guy.
Absolutely.
I hate to admit it. He's a good-looking guy too. He's a great guy. And also you have a newcomer, Shobana Shankar.
Right.
And Nati Kumar is a director.
Two of them. It's a director duo.
Right.
This is kind of a new experience for me because Nati Kumar and Dr. Jay are the directors of this movie. So it's been a tremendous experience so far.
So you're co-producing and you're also acting. You're the lead role.
Yes.
The lead actress role, I
will.
What's been your experience so far shooting in Silicon Valley?
Absolutely fantastic. Like I said, this is the first movie I am filming in the United States. And the locales are beautiful. The people have been absolutely wonderful. We have had like a picnic atmosphere because the directors are just a lot of fun to work with. And
so tell me, Kalpana, what have been some... So this is the first film you've shot in the U.S.
Yes.
And I know you live in the U.S.
Right.
Your past projects have been Bollywood-centric. Tell the viewers what you've done in the past.
Okay. Well, I have done several projects, mostly on a short-term basis in Bollywood because I also have another full-time profession in the United States.
We'll talk about that.
And so that has limited my appearance in films so far. I have been flying back and forth as and when I had time, go down to Mumbai and do appearances in films which have caught my fancy. So I have, my first experience was a fantastic film. I got to work with legends of the Indian film industry. It was called Wow. Gajgamini, directed by Mr. M.F. Hussain.
Right.
And that
Madhuri Dixit.
Had Madhuri, yes, Madhuri Dixit, Shabana Azmi, Nasiruddin Shah, and Shah Rukh Khan. So I got a chance to work with the all-time greats in my first movie, and that
wow.
was wonderful.
Wow.
So post that, I've just been flying back and forth. I did Moksha with, the hot and happening Arjun Rampal, I guess. So it was a fantastic experience there. And we I did a number, which was... which
Chanaleva?
Great. Oh, yes.
I've seen it about 250 times.
Okay.
That's a hot number. That's great. You did fantastic. And not a. So after this, what do you have? What are your future projects?
Okay, like I said, I've just come up with my production company, House of Pandit, and we did a beautiful film. It's actually in my native language, Kannada, and I chose Kannada because I grew up in Karnataka, and it's English subtitle, so it's an international project. It's called Jojo Lali, and it's based on a classical dancer.
Right.
Who falls in love with a photographer, has a baby, and then there's a twist in the story, and there's the subject of AIDS, agonizing emotional story, which has been very well received.
And you actually sent it to a couple of international film festivals, didn't you?
Yeah, it's gone. It's more than a couple, actually. It's in the process of going to more.
So it's called Jojo Lali, produced by Kalpana Pandit, mm-hmm. House of Pandit.
House
I apologize,
Pandit.
Starring Kalpana Pandit.
मेरे फोटो क्यों खींच रहे हो?
मैं तो बस सुंदर चीजों की फोटो ले रहा था. आप सुंदर लगे, आपकी भी ले ली.
हमारे बीच में जो था वो सब क्या था आकाश? वो भी सब एंजॉयमेंट के लिए था? बोलो.
वेलकम बैक व्यूअर्स टू एक मुलाकात. आई एम योर होस्ट रवि शास्त्री एंड आई एम हियर विद द ग्लैमरस एंड गॉर्जियस एंड फैंटास्टिकली ब्यूटीफुल कल्पना पंडित. कल्पना, वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट जोजो लाली बिफोर द ब्रेक. I understand it's been picked up by Hollywood, or rather, Hollywood has shown a lot of interest in that movie.
Oh, I'm very excited, Ravi. Jojo Lali has been viewed by a Hollywood distribution company called Quantum Releasing, and they have actually picked it up for worldwide distribution. So this is a big plus for me, my very first home production being picked up by Hollywood. So, so keep our fingers crossed, viewers. I need your good wishes because let's see where it goes from here. And now, just for your information, for people who would like Jojo Lali in Hindi, we've got it dubbed in Hindi. So
Hindi and Kannada, right?
Hindi, Kannada, wow. English subtitles. So it's truly kind of an international film.
So Hollywood wants to, distribute this,
yes,
you said?
They're looking at worldwide distribution.
What do you have after all of this? You have the movie, the present movie, Panithuli, the bilingual movie. You're finishing that. I think you're going to India to complete the shooting, mm-hmm. right? What do you have after that lined up?
I'm very excited about my next home production. So, as you know, I'm co-producing Panithuli.
I know.
The next one's going to be a solo home production again. It is in Hindi, a feature film. And much as I would love to tell all of you about the plot, I would rather wait for you all to wait for the movie to come out,
No, this is great. So this is in, the concept's out, you have the script ready.
Mm-hmm.
After this movie you're in, mm-hmm. you're going to go get on that project.
And it's going to be directed by the same excellent director who did my first home production, Mr. Sandeep Malani. And I'm hoping that we'll be able to create a fantastic movie again.
Now, when you get up in the morning, mm-hmm. Kalpana, what drives you? What is the first thing that goes through your head? What gets you out of bed and, into action?
Hot vanilla coffee. But other than that, I think in general, me being a Scorpio, I guess, I have an innate fire in me. I have a drive to do the best I can in the fields I love. And one of these fields is cinema. I mean, I'm in love with the celluloid, the world of celluloid. And it's a dream world, and I think it's amazing to create great products for the world to see. Because maybe later me and Ravi will discuss my other profession for a little bit, but this profession, I think entertainment is something that's absolutely essential in the world, and I'm a big believer in giving quality entertainment. So that's one of my driving forces.
Fabulous. Now you obviously, you're in great shape. What's your workout regimen? You work out every day. I mean, obviously, you got the energy to do it. What do you do? What do you do to stay fit, to stay on top of things, to be in that peak physical condition to deliver on your projects?
Well, thank you for the compliment, Ravi. I think I'm still working on getting in peak shape. But anyway, as I already said, I love dance, you know, so I try to get in as much dancing as possible. That's one of my fitness mantras.
All right.
And other than that, I've fallen in love with yoga, and lately hot yoga. It's
hot yoga?
Yeah, hot yoga. I'm finding,
I mean, I knew yoga was hot, but this is hot yoga.
This is hot yoga. I mean, it's literally hot yoga. 104 degree temperature, 1.5 hours straight. It just, you know, just cleanses you out like that, mental, physical, spiritual. When you come out, you're a new person.
So you basically sweat.
Oh, yeah.
You sweat out the toxins.
Absolutely. And it's a more recent hobby I've gotten into, but I'm finding it very, very appealing. So that's one of my other ones. And right. I love massages.
No, of course, who doesn't, right?
Who doesn't, yeah.
Now, so Kalpana, tell me, you live in the U.S. How do you manage this whole experience of working in two different continents? You know, you've done movies in India, you mm-hmm. live here. How does that work?
I think it works fantastic so far, don't you think? No, I mean, let me say I've been very lucky, very blessed, because I do... work. I did study partly here, and I did study in India, so I have a very strong base in both countries. I have a very strong South Indian base in me, and I'm very proud of that. And being a modern woman in America, I think the base that I got in South India has helped me just flourish and bloom out here. So I thank my family for that. I thank them for giving me a great upbringing. And the fact that I'm able to just go back and forth is a huge plus, a huge blessing. And I don't take that for granted. I work very hard on all of that.
So you have a base, obviously, in South India, Bangalore.
Mysore.
Mm-hmm. And also in Bombay, right? Because mm-hmm. with your whole, mm-hmm. your activities around mm-hmm. Bollywood, mm-hmm. you have a base in Bombay as mm-hmm. well. So, Kalpana, what's your favorite food?
Well, that's quite a jump, Ravi.
Yeah, we're jumping all over.
I still thinking deep culture, background, and I go like, what's
your... We'll go back to that later.
Okay. You know, honestly, I'm quite a... I hear everyone use the word foodie, so I guess I'm quite a foodie because I love trying new stuff. And I'm trying to stay healthy just because I think it's a great way to live. It just gives you so much more energy. I try to stay away from junk food. But lately, I'm into the... I would say like oriental soups, you know, like with lotus roots and tofu and bamboo shoots.
Oh.
And yeah, like sizzling soups of that sort. That's my latest. And I keep changing. Let me say there's nothing called a one favorite food. Every 3 months, I just stop eating that food and then I go to a brand new food and that's my favorite for the next 3 months. So nice. That way I'm a little bit fickle. So
do you make this? Do you go out to eat?
Oh, you got in on my biggest dread of life. I can't cook.
Oh, really?
I can't cook to save my life. I never have, and I don't think I ever will. So that's something I'm sorry, I have to share it because it's my one.
So if Kalpana ever calls anybody for a home cooked meal, just say you're sick that day and don't show up.
No, I promise I'll get great catered food. I mean, I promise. I'll make sure that y'all have the best food, but it won't be made by me. Because you don't want to eat anything made by me, believe me.
Now, in addition to all your accomplishments, and your accomplishments as a cook, as a chef.
Thank you, Ravi. Don't rub it in, please. Do not rub it in. I'm not proud of the fact that I can cook.
You've been doing Bharatanatyam dancing for a long time, ever since you were a little girl. Tell us about that.
Oh, I I absolutely cherish it. And I shouldn't say I've been doing it lately, because living in the States and traveling back and forth all the time is pretty tough to have a regimen in Bharatnatyam. Right. But I have a very strong base. I had some amazing teachers when I was growing up in Mysore. I even would love to take their names, Krishna Veni and Mrs. Nandini Ishwar. They were my absolute instructors. And the base that they gave me in dance is helping me so much in films today. It's given me a lot of grace. It's given me rhythm, and I'm ever thankful to them. But yeah, I would love to practice Bharatnatyam as much as possible, but it's a bit hard nowadays.
I've always wondered how Bharatnatyam dancers, how well they can do in, I guess, modern Bollywood kind of dance. But from what you're saying, the classical dancing gives you a base.
Not just a base, Ravi, it also
style,
adds...
Style, form.
Yeah, and the discipline that you acquire as a classical dancer in your childhood, that stays with you forever.
Right.
And I see that difference, you know, in maybe girls who have not learned traditional styles of dancing versus those who have learned.
Right.
It just adds an entire base of discipline, grace, focus, I would like to say. Yeah.
Absolutely, absolutely. Now, absolutely fascinating. And do you still practice? Do you still dance Bharatnatyam when you have a moment?
When I have the time, yes, absolutely. I have these audio cassettes, the old audio cassettes, which I've converted into CDs, and I try to remember those steps. I go through the riyaz or the sadhana, what they call it. It's beautiful.
Wonderful, wonderful.
It's a devotion. It's dedication. Divine dedication. And much as it may sound corny, it's not. Believe me, it's not. Because that's what is giving me the base for my modern dancing. So,
let's talk about Pita. You did a video, was it? A music video?
It was actually a movie. It was a well-received movie directed by Mr. Mahesh Manjrekar. And with Sanjay Dutt as the main lead guy.
Oh, I apologize. And, it was a full-fledged
movie. But I did a number which was choreographed by the all-time great again, Master Ji Saroj Khan.
Oh my goodness.
Oh my gosh. I had the honor of working with her, and I shall never forget it. So we had this beautiful mujra number shot over 7 nights.
Are you serious?
9 p.m. to 5 a.m. every night. And this was in a haveli set in...
9 p.m. to 5 a.m., not 9 a.m. to 5 p.m.
No, it was the opposite.
And the reason for that being...
Because the ambience was night. It's haveli, it's night.
Oh, right, right.
And it was a massive number, and it was shot in Panvel. And Mr. Om Puri, who's another fantastic artist, was part of our...
The Om Puri himself?
I've had the honor of working with some very, very wonderful artists.
Right.
So that was a mujra number which I cherish, because it had its own style and it was choreographed by Master Ji Saroj Khan. So I would love to show you.
ढीला ढाला घागरा तू पे तंग तंग चोली लेके आई ऐसन जवानी चल गई ना गोली अरे हम कब देके जाओ कोनो निशानी कहां लेके जाओगी इन नमकीन जवानी आए
मेरी जवानी किसको
चुमत चुमत
इसको मिलेगी उसको मिलेगी
चुमत चुमत
मेरी जवानी किसको मिलेगी इसको मिलेगी उसको मिलेगी मेरी जवानी किसको मिलेगी इसको मिलेगी उसको मिलेगी लगा है दीवानों में सट्टा लाखों हुए बेईमान जो सरकार
Viewers, welcome back. Kalpana, a lot of viewers may not even know that you are, in addition to all your accomplishments as an actor, a producer, and a dancer, people don't know that you are a fully licensed doctor. Tell us more about that.
Yeah, I let me say that again. I feel very blessed to be able to work in two different highly motivating, highly challenging professions. I work in emergency medicine. I'm actually an internal medicine certified doc, but I work in emergency rooms, and for me that's impressive. A very, very challenging. It's a high stress profession, but I love it, and I think that's what makes me feel the happiest when I'm in the emergency room,
right.
Working to I mean.
You're saving lives.
Yeah, I mean, working to help patients is what I would say. Help make them feel better. So, yeah, I mean, that's something that is a complete opposite of what I experience in my work with movies.
Right.
And I love both of them because this is, it's all focused on basically saving lives, working on, split-second decisions, trying basically it's just...
I mean, it's on the feet thinking. You are a doctor.
Exactly.
Someone who's got a heart attack. You could have
a
bullet wound.
You hit the nail on the head.
It could be anything, right? And
right,
here you
right.
are doing this.
Yeah.
And a couple of months later, you are in a Bollywood movie.
Right.
I find that absolutely the most fascinating thing about you is that you can really do both of these things and well.
And like you said, for me, movies is actually a huge stress buster. I don't even consider it work, because for me, moving from that profession to this is just the opposite. And I believe that me entertaining people in the movie field is just it's a huge, huge stress buster.
Now talking about movies, mm-hmm. back again, tell us about working with Preetam. I mean, you tell the audience all about that.
Okay, this was a fantastic music video. I got an opportunity to work with the music composer extraordinaire, Preetam Chakraborty.
Everyone knows him.
Yeah. And great I guy. Love his music. I mean, I've been following his music for the past few years. And when I had the opportunity, I was like, thrilled. So we shot this beautiful music video in and around Mumbai called Khuda Na Kare. And it was sung, composed, written, everything by Preetam. And he's also acted in the video. And it's a romantic ballad. It had just me and him and his band. Like I said, it was shot in very exotic locales in and around Mumbai.
Lastly, before I let you off the hook, what are some of the actors, both Hollywood, Bollywood, that have actually inspired you?
A lot actually. In the recent times, of course, I mentioned Dark Knight already. I was deeply impressed by Heath Ledger's performance.
Of course.
Yeah, I tend to get fascinated by the more slightly grayer shades in performance rather
right.
than outright
right.
straight, you
right.
know, hero type or heroine type
right.
performances.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Right.
And another one, very, very latest one was The Black Swan. I was just blown over by Natalie Portman's...
She did great.
Oh, man, what a performance. I would love to do a role like that, but, maybe with time. So, one of those. And then in Bollywood, I have so many. And most of them are, I guess, Sridevi, an all-time favorite.
Right.
Yeah.
Sridevi is a great actress, and she's got a lot of fan base.
Yeah,
and
she was a very commercial actress, but also did a lot of great art-type films also. And just so popular. People mm-hmm. love her. I mm-hmm. love her. And again, Madhuri Dixit, an all-time favorite again.
Classic beauty. That's what Madhuri Dixit
mm-hmm.
is.
And a great dancer, of course. That's one thing that just inspires me
right.
so much.
Right.
And guys, always Amitabh Bachchan first. Always.
He still takes
nobody,
the cake. Always.
Yeah. I can't even think. It's always him first, and then whoever.
Right.
And I guess I love Shah Rukh Khan's movies.
Right.
And who else? I mean, there's a lot of them.
There's a lot of that.
Now,
given all this, you like Johnny Depp. Because he acts in the most unusual roles, right?
Yeah, he's good. But
Johnny Depp is my favorite. I like Johnny Depp because, of, like you said, he can act as a cool secret agent, swashbuckling
mm-hmm.
hero,
mm-hmm.
a pirate, a crazy guy.
Mm-hmm.
He can do a lot of different roles. I like
mm-hmm.
that. So,
Yeah, Johnny Depp is pretty good. Yeah. Who else can I think of in Hollywood?
There's
too many. I mean, there's so
much. How about Kalpana Pandit? I'm a big fan already.
Thank you, Ravi. That's sweet.
Now, with that, I thank you very much for coming to our studios, making time. I know you've had an extremely hectic and a busy schedule. We've had some going back and forth and trying to get this to work for you. But thank you for making the time. Thank you for gracing the cameras and our show with your magnificent presence. You look gorgeous.
Thank you, Ravi.
And, we're all just awestruck, if you will.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank
it's
you.
Been a pleasure.
Thank you. Pleasure is and all ours. And,
and all the viewers of Ek Mulaqat, I'm very, very happy to be here. And I hope I get the opportunity to speak with all of you again. Please do watch all my movies and support them. And that's all I ask of you. So enjoy the new year. It's a new decade. And lots of love to all of you.
Thank you, everybody. And look out for the video from Pritam.